are not tax cheats.
Conservative leader Andrew Scheer and Prime Minister Justin Trudeau in one of their fiercest exchanges yet, prompted by the government's proposed changes to tax law.
We've already established that this isn't fair.
That's not right.
The government says it's closing loopholes used by some high-income earners to pay lower tax. But opponents, and they organized quickly, say small business owners will be hurt the most.
Corporations are not loopholes.
Some of the loudest voices of opposition coming from doctors and their professional associations, saying this is bad enough to make some of them take their skills and leave the country.
You've got to remember, physicians are portable, and there are jobs across the border and other places as well.
Justin Ling is a journalist with Vice News. He decided what this debate needed was some good old-fashioned clarity.
Just the facts, ma'am.
So he and a colleague put together an explainer on the current system and what could change. But in such a polarized debate, can journalists be seen as honest brokers? Or based on what we find, are we inevitably seen as taking sides?
Okay, so lots of ground to cover here, but let's start at the beginning. How on earth did this debate over tax policy, most people just like, you know, snooze when you say it, it suddenly became polarized, even sexy?
Yeah, well, you know, I think it's an issue that actually touches a good chunk of people, not a majority, not even a big plurality, but, you know, probably tens of thousands, maybe hundreds of thousands of people across the country, and they're going to be personally affected by this. And when you personally raise someone's taxes, they don't always respond so positively. And I think some of the government's rhetoric on this was a little overheated. You know, the word tax cheats came out,
right.
The word loophole came out. Everyone hates that word. So I think people responded pretty viscerally. And I think
you had these organizations like the CMA coming out as well. We don't normally hear them wade into this kind of a public debate.
Yeah, so, you know, these private corporations have been kind of an unspoken agreement for a long time. For the doctors specifically, they forwent some rate hikes in exchange, kind of an unspoken deal to say, we're not going to pay you anymore, but, you know, if you use these corporations, we're going to turn a blind eye. That deal is kind of off now, and the government is saying these corporations are no longer to be used for the specific purpose. We've also seen these corporations get more used recently because the government added a new tax bracket on the very top earners in the country, and these corporations were used increasingly, it seems, to avoid that very top tax bracket.
You and your colleagues decided to go, okay, we'll look at the tax changes, we'll look at what's in place now, what would change? Just so we've got some kind of honest broker template to look at. So what kind of reaction did you get? Were you seen as an honest broker?
Yeah, actually, you know what? I will say most of the reaction was pretty positive. Of course, there was people on Twitter. There's always people on Twitter who are going to call me a partisan and a hack and so on, and I'm carrying water for the government. But, you know, I think the mainstream media, a lot of the big networks, a lot of the big newspapers did everyone a disservice in this debate because they tried to do a back and forth between CMA, between the government, between farmers, between the government, and they were printing opinions that had very little basis in reality. And I think it was really incumbent on somebody to sit there and go, No. You know what? We have to break down what's actually changing, who's right about this, and who's wrong about this. That's not to say the changes are good, not to say the changes need to be done, just to say, here's what they actually do, and here's who's basically spreading disingenuous information.
Okay, but even what you wrote, though, you concluded that one of the loopholes was an absurd tax loophole, something else unquestionably dodgy. Isn't that language that leads people to one conclusion or another?
Yeah, maybe. But I think there's also, you know, fair comment. I think for a journalist, if you go through some, you know, government policy and you really kick the tires on it and try to get out of the fray of the back and forth, it's fair to, at the other end of that, go, you know, I've really looked at this, I've looked at who this impacts, I've looked at what it does, and, you know, fair enough. And just because a loophole is, you know, maybe a little bit absurd doesn't mean it has to go away. You can still make the case for and against it.
Really interesting. And I like your point as well when you say that the media has been caught on this issue and others in that he said, she said, only time will tell kind of narrative, and that this is trying to take it somewhere else.
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. I think when we start falling into that trap of just reporting the back and forth, it gives, you know, lobby groups, it gives political parties a big open window to just come in and say whatever they want, because at a certain point, it gets reported. The vast majority of the people this impacts are, you know, professionals, people who have their own corporation where they're the sole owner, the sole employee, and that who are earning over $200,000 a year.
We've done it. We've had an interesting conversation about tax policy. Thank you.
Hopefully, yeah, thanks.